So if you're looking for some accessories for the Sony ZV-1, in this video, I'll try my best to cover all the needed accessories that you cannot leave your house without. Get your wallet ready because all the product that we'll mention will be linked in the description section below. So without further ado, let's get started. So this goes without saying, but you definitely need a good memory card with decent capacity. The minimum I can recommend is 64 gigs of SD card, and with that, you will get an hour and a 15 minute of 4K video recording. I definitely recommend going up to 128 gigs because you will get twice of the recording time. And try not to get cheaper by getting less known brands. Instead, go with the one with good reputation if you don't want to end up with corrupted videos. Next up is the batteries. So you need to get at least two of these batteries as the recording in the Sony ZV-1 isn't that long. What suit my needs is the NPB1, and with that, you will get an hour before the battery drains down. If your budget is a bit tight, I suggest to get this pack of three batteries with a charger and save yourself some money. This one is a really nice pocket-sized light that can go on top of your Sony ZV-1 camera and provide a bit of illumination on your face if you want to get the best lighting while vlogging in low light situation. Next up is a tripod. Sony actually sells a vlogger kit that you can get with the camera or buy it separately. The tripod itself, it's pretty cool. You can do a lot with it, as trigger the zoom, take pictures, and also start recording. Or you can also get this universal octopus tripod and get more flexibility. For me, the Ulanzi MT11, it's what suits my needs the most. Tripod legs are made of metal and covered with rubber for more control. You can hold a camera up to 2 kilograms, and you get also a mounted hole on the side in order to mount an extra accessories if you need it. The plate also can be converted to a phone holder, which is really handy. Or you can get yourself this long tripod that can go up to 80 centimeters. This one is very handy for long distance shot, taking selfies or filming your legs for a B-roll shot, for example. The arm itself is very robust, made from strong material, and it offers a good quality straight out of the box. Next up is the stabilizer. Yes, the Sony ZV-1 has a good stabilization, but not the best in the world. It doesn't get rid of the up and down movement 100%. For me, I found the Zhiyum Cron M2 is the perfect choice for all the smooth stabilization footage that you can see on my videos. It's just really easy to use. No need to be a pro to start using it. Just turn on the gimbal and let the show begin. For me, this gimbal is the best investment I've ever made. It's one of the most needed accessories that I cannot leave my place without. One of its biggest points is the form factor and how small it is. And also, being a universal gimbal, it's a huge plus. I featured in one of my preview videos. If you don't see it already, go watch it right now. Let's talk microphone. The wiring board in the Sony ZV-1 is pretty much advanced. It offers a good quality straight out of the box. However, for my personal use, I found using the Rode Wireless Go is the perfect choice to get the most of your camera. It matches very well the form factor of the Sony ZV-1, looking how tiny it is, and it works very well in a lovely environment by isolating all your voice. By the way, I'm using it right now to record this video, so you can judge. Next up is the L bracket. I picked this one from UURIG, and it's nice because it gives you a way better grip and it has a bunch of holes all around it, so you can attach all different types of accessories. What's really cool about this gauge is that you can still have access to the battery section along with the SD card, which is very practical and saves you a lot of time, especially when your camera is already mounted in a tripod and you don't want to unmount again to remove your full SD card or your empty battery. The Sony ZV-1 is known by having a tight lens, and it's not wide enough. It comes out of the box with 24 to 17 millimeters. However, with the active stabilization on, the Sony ZV-1 crops in, so you're only looking at 30 millimeters. Lucky enough, I found the perfect solution for this little problem. This one is the Ulanzi WL1. The ring diameter is 52 millimeters, and it's come with an extra glass for macro shot. This lens is something I think every Sony ZV-1 owner should have in their camera bag, because it helps with those landscape shots and especially to add that extra space in the background while vlogging.
Alright, to test how wide the Ulanzi lens is, let's see a before and after so you can guys judge. So this is right now is with the lens already mounted in. Right now I'm gonna take it off. Guarding always the same distance. And there you go. This is without the lens. Alright, we'll start by taking some pictures to see how wide is the camera with and without the lens. Let's do that. Pretty amazing, right? Now let's see the macro lens and see what this bad boy can do. I'm really impressed with the quality of this glass. Even though it's a bit heavy, I don't know if it's gonna impact the motors of the camera in the future. A simple workaround is to turn the camera upside down when you want to turn it on and face it up when you want to turn it off. This way, you won't impact the motors a lot, I guess. All right, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. Please let me know in the comments which accessories you found it more useful. And again, all the links will be in the description section below. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're new to this channel. Guys, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Peace out.